folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about how you can set up MinIO to interface with OpenID or LDAP so that you can have single sign-on and you can manage all of your users and groups externally to MinIO. Let's go ahead and take a look. At some point, it is likely to be the case that you are no longer going to want to use MinIO IDP. You have to manage MinIO IDP right through MinIO, and it's not centralized, and there's no single sign-on or anything like that. Your corporate environment probably already mandates the use of LDAP or OpenID or something to manage all of these logins, all of these policies and everything else. Now, the policy definition is still going to remain on MinIO. If I'm using OpenID, I can add a flag to tell OpenID to tell MinIO which policies it should try to attach. With LDAP, it goes the other way. You tell MinIO which policies to attach to which user or group coming from LDAP. So that's a little difference between LDAP and OpenID, but let's take a look at this. MinIO has connectors for OpenID and LDAP. When used, all of the user authentication is handled by the external service. Group membership can also be set. And when you enable this, the MinIO IDP is no longer used. Okay, the root user is still going to be available. Okay, because again, the root user isn't managed by MinIO IDP. So that's your failsafe. Your root user is your failsafe. Your policies are still assigned to the user by MinIO, but there's a couple of different ways that works. With OpenID Connect, the user authentication is done through the OpenID authorization code flow. Okay, so that's one of the methods that is available to OpenID Connect, but this is the only method that MinIO can work with. It has to use the OpenID authorization code flow. Some examples of an OpenID Connect supporting service are Google and Facebook, for instance. Okta also supports it, Keycloak from Red Hat, and we also have Dex is another commonly used OpenID Connect service. MinIO is going to look for a policy claim as part of the JSON web token that gets sent back as part of the OpenID Connect, okay? MinIO will then try to map the policies listed to that user. Okay. Now the policy is still under control of MinIO. MinIO is being asked to assign the policy. If the policy name doesn't match, no policy is assigned. You're back to your default deny. If you want more information on this, take a look at our documentation for setting up OpenID Connect. Connecting this, it's a very simple command. What we're going to do is we're doing MC admin IDP. We're doing OpenID in this case, and we're going to add this configuration. We're going to use a client ID and a client secret to connect to this config URL. In this case, we're using a Dex provider. What we're going to do is we're going to request a couple of different scopes. We want the OpenID itself. We also want any groups that the user is a member of, so we can get any group management that we need to have. And then we're going to redirect back to MinIO on this OAuth callback. We're also going to, in this case, I'm setting a claim name of policy. That's the default. But if I have the policy mapped to a different variable in my web token, I can map that differently using the claim name flag. That's how I would do this with OpenIDC. With LDAP, MinIO is going to hand off the authentication off to LDAP. Generally speaking, you want to use a read-only LDAP account. That account should really only have the privileges to authenticate and look up any users and groups. That's it. That's all it should be able to do. You don't want MinIO connecting to your LDAP server with some admin account where it's going to be able to make changes to your LDAP server. You don't want that. So LDAP is then going to provide the user's DN and group DN information back to MinIO. Once those details are returned, MinIO is going to assign policies based on the user or group DN. Now, this is important. I'm actually going to set the policy against the group or user DM through MinIO, right? LDAP isn't handing me a flag that says, give me this policy. I'm actually setting it through MinIO itself. So the management of the policy mapping is still done by MinIO. In OpenID, remember, OpenID will hand a policy list and MinIO will attempt to map them. So it's a little different. Okay. When I'm connecting to LDAP, here's a very simple identity LDAP setup. I'm connecting to this server address using a lookup user and a lookup password. Again, this should be a very minimal user that can only do lookups. And then here is my user DN search base and search filter. What I'm going to be looking for is users that have an SAM account name of the name that was passed during authentication in the example net DC. So that limits what I'm looking for. Now, notice this is just for user information. So this is going to be the authentication piece. Have to have this. If this is all that I have, though, when I start mapping policies, I'm going to have to map each and every policy individually to a specific SAM account name. Okay, that's going to be a little tedious. So we probably also want to do groups. Now, I can add group search to an existing identity. So this is the previous identity LDAP that I had before. I'm now just adding group search to this. I could also do this as one big long command, but that kind of filled up the slide. So I'm doing this on two separate pieces. The group search filter, again, the unique member name, %D, that takes the full DN of the user and looks for any group membership. So I'm still doing authentication as before. I have to have that user lookup, but now I'm doing a separate group lookup in the same base DN, DC example net, okay? Now, the exact formatting of these entries, unique member or SAM account name, that depends entirely on your LDAP deployment and how your LDAP server is storing this information. Okay, so I don't have any major control over that. You guys are going to have to figure out how your LDAP server is going to be returning that information. Once we have this, we now need to map the policy. MC admin IDP LDAP policy attach. We can also do detach. I can attach console admin. I'm going to attach console admin to a particular user. That's probably not a bad idea. Limit it to a particular user instead of a group. And then I'm going to take read write and I'm going to give that to a different group of maintainers, for instance. Okay. Now read write, console admin, these are our built-in policies. But again, we can attach to a user, a particular user, or a particular group. One other little difference here, notice dash dash user equals. It's not dash dash user space like it was when we were attaching policies before using the MinIO IDP. All right, so that is everything that you need to know about LDAP, OpenID, mapping your policies there. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen, or you can connect with us on Slack at slack.min.io. You can even just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the lab.